So, you know how to build embedded devices and you know a bit about programming computers, but you want to connect the two. One of the most popular ways to connect device to a computer is USB, but there is not much information on how to program both the computer and the device so that they communicate. Well, there is a USB to UART converter that you can attach to your device, but you have to run a COM terminal on the computer and have additional electronics to solder while your microcontroller supports USB natively. Maybe you would like to use this native USB functionality and write a native Linux driver that would speak to this device. I was trying to do just that for the last couple of months, and now I'd like to share what I've learned. And I will start with a little demonstration. So here is a development board that has a button attached to it. I'm opening a terminal window, moving it into view, checking that my device file is not yet present in the slash dev directory. Now attaching the device and checking if the file is present now. Okay, I have to give it a moment to update. Checking it again, and here is the new file called usb.drv_1. This file represents the device I have down here. If I read the file or write to it, the system will instead send USB requests to the board. Now, I need to have the super user privileges to work with devices. I am acquiring them now. Now, if I read this file, it will print out whether the button on the board is pressed. So, it outputs 0 when the button is not pressed, and if I press it now, the output should be 1. I have listed the directory accidentally, I need to read the file. Here, it prints 1. Try again with the button released, 0. The write operation is also redefined for this device file. Writing to the file will control this blue LED. Writing 0 will turn it off, writing 1 turns it on. So, yes, this is the device and driver I will be making. Let's get back to the presentation. The tutorial I have prepared is about 1.5 hours long. It teaches, among other things, a little bit of theory about USB in general, just enough for such a simple device. It demonstrates how to build a Linux kernel module, how to enable it to communicate with the user, and how to make it to send USB requests. So it takes quite a bit to connect an embedded device to a computer natively. Maybe you'll reconsider your choices and stick with the USB to UART converters, or maybe you'll find it simple enough to use the native USB capabilities of the microcontroller and write device drivers for computers. Now, a bit of disclaimers. I'm not an expert in USB programming or Linux drivers, so the tutorial may contain mistakes. The method I'm using is working though, and if you're interested in making such devices but have nowhere to start, this tutorial should provide a guideline. Also, I use an STM32 microcontroller in this tutorial. For a different device, the code will be different, of course, but general idea should remain similar. Lastly, I have included some errors I've made while learning. Some of these mistakes took me a while to figure out, so I thought it would be nice to include the solutions in the tutorial. So, if you're ready, let's take a look at the plan I'm gonna follow. First, I will tell about prerequisites for the hardware and software we'll need. Then I will show how to program a USB device, send and receive USB messages from the computer, and how to conduct some meaningful conversation between the host and device. Next, I will show how to build a basic Linux module and how an end user can communicate with it. Next, I will add some USB capabilities to the module and make it send custom requests to the device. And finally, I will implement this request in the device. That is it for now. We can move on to the next video.